Welcome, this is a recorded session of the Post-Quantum Cryptography Conference of the PKI Consortium. This conference would not have been possible without our sponsors in Trust, HID Global, and PQ Shield, and the organizational support of the Post-Quantum Cryptography Working Group of the PKI Consortium, in particular in Trust, Logius, TNO, and CWI.
Advisor at the Ministry of the Interior and Kingdom Relations, and she initiated the quantum security cryptography program for the Dutch central government. She's working in the field of cybersecurity and integrated security since 2009 for several organizations within the Dutch government. It's her passion to make the Dutch government more cyber resilient through collaboration. Well, maybe you go first, Anita, right? And maybe you go first. Okay, and then also Germain van der Velde, Senior Information Advisor at the Ministry of Infrastructure and Water Management of the Netherlands. Germain van der Velde is an IT advisor at the Ministry of Infrastructure and Water Management. He specializes in cybersecurity, digitalization, and digital technologies such as quantum AI and cloud. Germain focuses on topics as quantum technology, post-quantum cryptography, IT strategy, and national and economic security. He's also a member of the QVC Dive team. Germain. And
well, thank you for the opportunity to present you something about the Dutch central government's program of quantum secure cryptography. We do this presentation together, and we want to do this together to show everyone that it is about collaboration, because we have a very difficult trajectory in front of us. So, today we're going to give you a brief introduction. I will give you a brief introduction, and my colleague Anita will tell you more about the program. So, first of all, I want to discuss with you the PQC Migration Handbook that is published by TNO, CBI, and the Dutch Intelligence Agency. I think it's a perfect handbook to help organizations to prepare themselves to get quantum ready. And there's an important theme in this handbook, and this theme is about urgent adopters. So what is this urgent adopter? Well, urgent adopters can be defined as organizations that work with, for instance, medical data or sensitive information with a long confidentiality span, but also organizations that provide critical infrastructure. So, if an organization works with this kind of data or infrastructure, then you should act now because you are an urgent adopter. So, this program for the Dutch central government, why is that important? Well, actually, this is the reason. Quantum technology has the ability to disrupt the lives of, our citizens, of everyone. So, it is really important to get quantum secure solutions on time. So, what is then the program that we have for the Dutch central government? Well, it's about quantum secure cryptography. And our aim is not to implement post-quantum cryptography, but it is about mitigation of these risks of quantum technology. And we also want to stress that Dutch ministries and their departments are responsible themselves in mitigating these risks on time. So this program we have, it has three pillars. It's about creating awareness and sharing knowledge. It's also about creating adequate policy frameworks and guidelines to support the Dutch ministries and the departments. And also it's about offering guidance and a center of expertise in order to facilitate and support the quantum secure solutions and mitigations of risk of
you very much. I will tell you about how we do it, because it's a collaboration program. And we only can do support the ministries because they have this own responsibility. And how do we do it? We have this steering board. We, in the Netherlands, for the central Dutch government, we have this information strategy. And we have a steering board on part two of that. And the theme of part two is digital resilience. And there is a steering board. And the program is part of digital resilience in the E-strategy. And the steering board is also steering on this program. And then we have this advisory board with external partners, science and research. Also, Ronald, he is part of our advisory board, and we are very happy about it, and also TNO and TU Delft. And we have some internal members for internal perspective. We have some two CTOs, because the challenge is mostly, at the end, a technology as challenge. And we also have a CISO and a CIO who are part of our advisory board. And then we have this program management and a central team who set out the lines. And beneath, we have this from various ministries and execution organizations. Also, the IVD, the National Cybersecurity Center, and some departments, they're part of our central team who set out the lines and make this happen. And we have this very large working group with more than 30 people from all over the central Dutch government. Also, police are collaborating with us. Logius also, Logius is part of our team. And then we also work with internal IT servers providers, because the change must be done there. And we also have auditors and supervisors part of our team, because at the end, supervising can help to make these things work. And we are starting a collaboration with in the public, private, and research community, because we need each other. We need also private partners to help to make us quantum secure. And then we have this, I saw before, quantum readiness, and we have this roadmap with the three pillars Jermaine just mentioned, and that will help us to become quantum ready. That is, readiness is through that, and why, how we do it. We do it through people, process, and technology. We take it all. We work on awareness and urgency. We have to act now. So we talk also not only to technology people, but also to the board. Because at the end, they have to have money to make it happen. Then we do it on process. We give direction on what we must do through policy, guidelines. We also help service delivery management. Right now, we are doing a pilot on helping service delivery management to talk with our major IT providers, because if we are an urgent adopter, also are our IT providers, because they have to build in quantum secure cryptography in the products. So we are asking them, how are you preparing? So we help service delivery management with a tool so that they can ease their talk with our service providers. And at the end, so we also do this technology track to help everyone, but how can we do it? And you see, because organizations are responsible themselves, some of them are doing these pilots in inventory or in how do we do our own roadmap. And we want to connect them so that they, all the pilots, can learn from each other, but also the program can learn from these pilots and put the knowledge back into the program. And because we have this agile program and developments are uncertain, each year we make a report on, hey, how are the developments going? What are the internal needs? Is there a change in technology development? Must we speed up, or can we do it in the how we do it now? So that's how we are going to do it, and the steering board is going to make the decisions on how fast we must go. And I only show this right now because tomorrow we want to discuss this with you. We have this model, and we want to challenge you and discuss with you this model. So I don't want to say too much about it, this, because we want to have this talk with you and discuss with you. It's on a parallel track at 10 a.m. Tomorrow about our main challenges, and maybe you can help us out here. So that's our talk for now. Are there any questions?
Are there questions for Anita and Germain?
One simple question. I saw in your scheme that you are really starting early with awareness. Well, we have actually struggled with awareness. Basically, by making too much noise early on the process, you're afraid that when we meet the awareness, we have lost the attention. So we are actually currently postponing any kind of awareness, and basically you are just starting to drop hints on post-quantum crypto for the bigger tech communities at least. How do you do that? Because I really saw you made everyone aware in 2023, and probably everyone has forgotten, I fear at least. How do you handle that?
Yes, it's a good question. Because when you want to really put it into the mind of people, you need to do it over and over and over again. So this is in 2023, this is the first time. So we have this communication strategy that we, next year, we reach the community in another way, but with the same message. So we do it over and over and reach out to different communities and different ways. Sometimes we send a message, sometimes we talk to them. What are your problems? How can we help you? So doing it over and over again is I learned it from someone who has studied communication. He said you must do it over and over in different ways, different times, and repeat, and then it goes to the minds. And we
have this different message for different kinds of audience. To technological people, we have another message than to the board. And we are also doing this, creating this education for IT personnel, and it becoming available next year so that they have to put up a new knowledge about cryptography they need in their work. So we're doing this on every target audience.
Yeah, good. I think it's time to thank Anita and Germain for their contribution.
In today's complex, fast-paced world, you need a partner who can help secure your digital transformation so you can drive your business forward confidently. Someone who can fine-tune and integrate the secure technologies that enable mobile identities, digital payments, and a hybrid workforce. You need a partner who will have your back so you can stay focused on the road ahead and accelerate your organization's growth. Entrust, securing a world in motion.